All right, so I went ahead and started this. I got into it and I thought, you know, it'd be nice to put some information out there for people who might want to do a similar thing to their Hudson, their step down, or honestly, some of this information would be useful for some other vehicles. But this is my 50 Hudson pacemaker. Four-door, and I'm putting some airbags in it, and there's zero information out there for any Hudsons that I could find, any real useful information. I have seen that there have been a few people put Air Ride in their Hudson, but of course no information out there that I could find on how to do it or problems and solutions and things like that. So basically, I thought it would be a good idea to go through some of this stuff. I'm going to leave out all the you know, things that are obvious, you know, like, you know, taking all of this stuff apart initially. If you don't know how to do that, don't try to install any suspension. If you can't take apart you know, your stock stuff here, don't even attempt it. I'll just say that. But anyhow, so where I am right now is I have unbolted everything here. Let me get under here and I'll swing this back down so you can kind of see how things sort of were. All right, so this looks a little more familiar. And of course, you know, this is linked in here. This sort of would be up here. So basically, you unbolt everything here. I actually broke my link here for my sway bar, but you know, I could, I'm sure, replace that with, maybe I can buy another one or whatever. Anyway, so unbolt everything. I just swung this up completely out of the way. And I know my frame is atrocious, but, you know, I can clean that up. Anyhow, so I unbolted everything. I got my airbags. Now, these are 2600 airbags. You see there? Pretty big. I went ahead and bought. I was going to use some different ones, but I thought, you know, what the heck. So I got the 2600. And I put it in here just for a trial fit, just to see how everything would work out. Got a plate on the bottom. So it actually fits. This plate that I have actually fits in here pretty well. So I think what I might do, I might have to trim this just a little bit. We'll know once we get there. I know I'm going to have to trim this plate, or maybe get rid of it altogether and put another plate on there, weld it in, because I do want to keep my bump stop. Anyhow, so do that. Once we get there, you'll see it. But I might be able to just put my plate in there. All right, so so far what I've done, working on the upper mount for the airbag, and this is what I've got. I just bought a universal kit from eBay. This is some pretty heavy-duty stuff. Probably some overkill. But anyhow, what I got when I bought it, some of these plates had a hole here in the middle. I got two different lengths of this pipe. I'll call it pipe. A 6-inch and a 3-inch. Now, the 6-inch... For what I'm doing here, 6 inches is too long, because you don't, the stock suspension, you don't have a lot of room there. When it's at ride height, there's not much room between here and here on the vehicle. There's not a lot of room there, so the 6-inch was too long. The 3-inch was not long enough. It would work, but I would have to trim out a lot of this here and the cross member. Because the cross member is so big, I'd have to trim out a lot of the cross member. I'm still going to have to trim some of that cross member, and maybe just a little bit of this here, this lip here. I think I might go ahead and trim that off, but we'll see once we get there. But basically what I did, I got the 6-inch piece, the 6-inch length pipe, and I cut it to 4 inches. So when it's up in there, this plate is just about even with the bottom of this lip. So that's why I say I'm not sure if I'll have to trim that off or not. I might go ahead and do it, I don't know. But so it fits in there pretty well, 4-inch piece. Fits in there pretty well. Now, of course, you have to have a way to mount that cup in there, which is where the threaded rod comes in. Now, if I'm not mistaken, this is, I'm not going to tell you size because I don't remember. Anyhow, I got this threaded rod, and I actually got a nut. Let me grab the microphone. This is the plate, what the plate looks like. And I got a nut that fit that threaded rod, and I ground down the sides of the nut so it would fit in into this hole. Okay, and I pressed the nut into that hole to where it was flush on one side, and then I welded it in. Put a couple tacks on one side. Once I knew everything was going to be right, then I put a little more weld on and ground it down. So then I had a nut, you know, sticking up on this side, and I could put the threaded rod into it. And I'll put the threaded rod almost all the way down, flush. And then I welded it in. Okay? So then it can't come out. Now, you might not think that's a good idea, whatever, but that's what I did, and that's how it's staying. But so I put the nut in, welded it, put a couple tacks on it, put the threaded rod into the nut, and then welded on the back side, welded the threaded rod into the nut. So it's all now basically one piece. This, the nut, and the threaded rod is one piece. And we end up with this. So you can see there. Right there, my welds suck, I know. But so that's basically what we have. 4-inch piece of length of pipe here. And the plate and the threaded rod. So basically, this fits up into here, and you can see there, this is the stock shock mount, and that fits up in there like that. You can see in there the piece of pipe coming up, flush, you put a nut on that, tighten it down, and bingo, you got it. Now you can see, that's just about, now that sticks down a little bit, but you know, not too bad. That's actually really good for what I'm doing here. So about the thickness of that plate. It's sticking out there, which is pretty good. Then, of course, the bag mounts to this. So it'd be the airbag under this, and then a plate on the bottom of the bag that would then mount in here. Now you can put a plate here, whatever. But all right, so once I figured out, you know, how I'm going to mount all this, put the threaded rod, you know, all that kind of stuff, I put this piece up in there, tightened it down, put the bag under it, and I connected the bag to it and set it in here, and I jacked this up, and I jacked it up all the way as far as the airbag could collapse, which would be you airing the vehicle down. So I jacked this up to collapse that bag as much as it should be collapsed. And then I looked around at everything where it was touching everything. Now one place, the first place that I'm working on is at this upper bump stop. This piece used to be down here. And there was a section in the middle here. Now, it was hitting on the back side of it. I've cut some of that off already, but you know, it was down here like this, and that bag was hitting up against the back part of it. And I thought, well, I want to keep this bump stop. So I'm going to attempt to cut out this center section that was here and then move this up then weld it back together basically and back to the frame. And you can see that I've got it pretty much, you know, right on there. And I'm going to weld that back together, weld it to the frame, which from the factory, those welds were bad. They weren't. Now, not that every car was going to be like that, but you know, this one, it wasn't stuck on there that great. But you know, I'm going to weld that up, weld it back on there, and then I have a factory looking mount for my bump stop still. So that's where I am right now, and that's what I'm about to do. All right, so got that started welding on there, as you can see. So just moved it up, welded it on, and now I've got plenty of clearance here. As you can see, under here is that lip, and this comes out flush with that. So if I can, I'll probably be leaving that lip on there. It's not in the way of anything, I don't believe, but this section, this cross member, is going to have to go. You know, I'll just probably plate that off. It's hollow now, but I'll cut off what I need to and then plate that. Clean it all out, put some rust inhibitor in it, which it looks like it needs, and plate it off. So, you can see, lift this up here. Alright. I have to get rid of that. This plate here, which is where that sway bar link mounted, is going to have to go. So probably what I'm going to do is grind out these rivets, take that plate off. There's actually another plate on the bottom of this, and I'll probably probably work this mount into the bottom instead of on top, so which will still work out even with the stock one or the stock link, because it's going to be so much higher, or the car will be so much lower, and it'll work out. Or I can just buy a different link, make it work. But anyhow, so next I'm going to be taking this plate off of here. I'll deal with relocating this mount later on. Right now I'm going to take this plate off, probably trim this down as much as I can to leave, like from here down, I'll leave this section and weld it on, maybe, we'll see. We'll see how everything works out. After I get that plate figured out, and I'll start working on this cross member, trim that out the best I can, and do some fitting, see what happens, and I'll get more video of that. All right, I had to turn the light on here, got dark on me, but you can see what I've done here is trimmed out the cross member, like I was saying, and a word of advice. Check for some nests from mice. See that in there? I had a bunch of smoke. I thought there was something on fire, but it could have been if I wouldn't have caught it. But yeah, check for that kind of stuff before you do any welding or cutting or grinding, anything like that. But, see, I cut that cross member out there. A decent amount, not a ton. It was this section here only came back to somewhere around here, and then it came up and over. It was already hollow. There was nothing right here at all. So I only cut out. Actually, I can show you here. This is what I cut out of it, and this was in there like that. Cut that out, and then just some small pieces I trimmed out. And then I decided to put a plate in here, weld a plate in, because the bag with this plate on the bottom, it would fit down in between here and here, but then the bag on compression would touch the sides here. And I didn't want to have to trim this off and box all this in. And, you know, I can't buy another one of these new. As far as I know, I can't find one anywhere. I'd have to buy one used, and finding one, you know, that I could afford is probably pretty hard to do. So I didn't want to do any of that. So I decided to put a plate in here, and I will drill a hole where I need to here for the bag. This is the bottom for it to mount, just like this plate does. And then the bag will mount that way. So that's where I am. Like I said, I had to trim out the center section of this, move it up, trim out part of the cross member. Oh, and this plate that was here, I don't know where it is right now, but it had the bump stop on it. I just ground down the rivets, which was a pain. But I ground those down, popped it out of there. So I have some more room there. Now I will put another plate, a smaller plate here eventually with the bump stop on it. I don't know actually now if I'm gonna need the bump stop. So I don't have a ton of travel on this anyway. Not as much as I would like to have. It is a fair amount, but seeing how I had to, you know, pretty much come up with all this myself, it's not too bad. And later on, you know, if I want to, I could change some stuff out. Maybe when I do my disc brake conversion, I could redo some stuff and all that. But that's later on down the road. Right now, the only thing I need to do is, you can see the back of that plate is hitting there. Now, I don't know if that's going to be an issue. I don't think my bag will compress that much. I really don't think it will. I'll put it in there and check. If I need to trim that off, this plate here, trim this plate off here. I won't trim any more of this. I'm actually going to get some plate and weld it in here. But I just would feel a lot better that way. Even though this was already, like I said, I only cut out that much of it, I would just feel better. And it would keep things like that from happening like that, like the mice getting in there, or mud and water and all that. So, but yeah, so next I'll be finding out where exactly I need to drill my hole here to mount my bag. And everything else, I haven't checked it 100% yet, but everything else here should clear just fine. I shouldn't have any issues with anything here. Now, I will check, of course, again once I get air in the bag to be sure. But if it is close, it won't require a lot of trimming. But anyhow, so yeah, that's where I am so far.
All right.
So I've got the bag mounted in there, welded in this plate, drilled a hole in it to mount the bag. It's actually the bolt going up through into it. Now there on the underside of this is a plate, the original plate from the Hudson, with an access hole to the lower shock mount. So I just used that, left that there, and I can get to the bolt really easily. So yeah, that's how it's mounted. Top bolt here and the bottom one down here. Everything fits pretty good. As you can see, I do have a little bit more room up here. I could move this up into that frame a little more to get just a little bit more drop, but I'm not sure if it's going to work out that way because of my steering linkage. It comes across here, and I'm not sure how much space I have between it and my frame rail. But that's a possibility, maybe later down the road, to get, you know, another half inch to an inch. But yeah, so just to go over all this again real quick, what I had to do to put a 2600 bag on the front of a 1950 Hudson pacemaker was, first I cut out the center section of this mount here for this bump stop, cut it out and moved this lower section up and welded it on. That way it doesn't, because it was dropped down pretty low and I didn't want it rubbing on that bag. I trimmed out the cross member, the lower portion of the cross member. I cut that out, put a plate in here, drilled a hole in it to mount the bag, which there are other options. I actually initially was going to use this and basically use build another cup like this, and it would set in there and the bag of course mounted on top, but that was a little too thick. Now it would have worked out just fine if I could have trimmed that down, but I don't have the tools to do that. So I just, you know, cut out a plate, welded it in there, mounted it up that way. Everything works fine. So yeah, the only things I have to do now, shock mount, not a big deal. You can do any of this stuff. You can easily put in a shock mount, and the mount for the end length of the sway bar. That's it. Put it all back together. So I'm going to get a video. I don't have any plumbing on this yet, but I'm going to get a video of this. I'll put all this back together and I'll put it at ride height, stock ride height, which was basically when I got this car, all of this was pretty much sitting on this bump stop. So I'm going to set it there. You'll see what that's like, and then I'll just basically jack it up with my tiny puny floor jack that I have, and you can see, you know, how much drop it has by lifting this up. So yeah.